Danas više život nije lak.
They will tell you that you must get zinc from animals.
Oni vam kažu da je neophodno da dobijete cink od životinja.
Because look, there's lots of zinc in beef, for example.
Na primjer, u govedini ima dosta cinka.
And milk also has some zinc.
U mlijeku ima nešto cinka.
But look at the beans and the grains, they also have zinc.
Ali pogledajte pasulj, na primjer, i druge namirnice na ovoj strani povrća, i one sadrže cinka.
Soja has 3.5 miligrams per
100 miligrama.
Lentils are not too bad.
Sočivo nije isto tako loše.
Popcorn is quite good.
Kokice su odlične na ovom području.
But look at the wheat bran and the wheat germ.
Pogledajte sada klice.
Klice, da, klice, klace, whatever.
Isklicane. That's it. Pustite ih da isklijaju i onda ih jedete.
Now notice that they are 9.8 and 14.3.
Pogledajte da su ovdje kod ovog crnog brašna i kod klica vrednosti cinka 9.8 i 14.3.
That's your best source of zinc.
To je vaš najbolji izvor cinka.
No wonder they take it away from you and give you refined flour with no zinc.
Nije čudo da uzimaju od vas ovo i onda vam daju nazad rafinisano brašno u kome nema cinka.
They don't want you healthy, they want you sick.
Ne žele da budete zdravi, nego da budete bolesni.
So if you make sure that you get whole foods and yellow foods and all kinds of colors,
tako da ako ste obezbedili da imate žutu hranu, zelenu hranu, sve boje,
and you're sensible about your B12 and occasionally you supplement when you see that it's necessary, then do that.
Osjetljivi ste na nedostatak B12 i s vremena na vreme uzmete dodatak, onda je okay.
And if you're pregnant, you need more than normal.
Ako ste u drugom stanju, onda je potrebno malo više nego normalno.
So be sensible and careful about what you do.
Tako da budete promišljeni i da znate šta radite u stvari.
Then we need some general guidelines.
A onda su nam potrebni neki uopšteni vodiči.
Do you know how many guidelines there are out there on how to live healthy?
Znate li koliko ima tih vodiča, pravila kako se živi zdravim načinom života?
So many that you will want to give up.
Toliko mnogo da u stvari dignete ruke od svega.
You're not allowed to eat what grows above the ground with what eats below the ground.
Nije dozvoljeno jesti ono što raste nad zemljom, nije ono što raste ispod zemlje.
You're not allowed to eat carbohydrates and proteins in the same meal.
Nije dozvoljeno jesti ugljene hidrate i bjelančevine u istom obroku.
You're not allowed to eat your fruit with your food.
Nije dozvoljeno sa ostalom hranom jesti voće.
You must only eat this way or that way or the other way or hundreds of rules.
Treba da jedete ovako, onako ili na određeni način, stotine pravila.
So you say,
nisam naučio da prevodim ovo.
Have you experienced that?
Popravit ću se.
I want to say that most of those rules are totally ridiculous.
Mogu da vam kažem da je gomila ovih pravila potpuno smešna.
For example, proteins and carbohydrates at the same meal.
Na primjer, belančevine i ugljeni hidrati u istom obroku.
Well, God made a big mistake when he made grain or legume or anything that you can eat.
Bog je onda napravio veliku grešku kada je stvorio žito, sve vrste žita ili mahunarke.
Because they all have carbohydrate and protein.
Zato što u svima njima ima ugljenih hidrata i belančevina.
The problem comes when you add animal protein.
Problem nastaje kad dodate protein životinskog porekla ili bjelančinu životinskog porekla.
Because it takes longer to digest.
Zato što za nju je potreban duži proces varenja.
But when you're dealing with plants, eating proteins and carbohydrates is no problem at the same time.
Ali kad iz biljaka uzimate ugljene hidrate i bjelančine, onda nemate problema.
So let's look at three rules. That's not so hard to remember.
A sada da pogledamo tri pravila, to nije teško da se čovjek podsjeti na ovo.
Eat an abundance of fruits, grains, nuts, seeds, legumes and vegetables.
Jedite u izobilju, to je prvo pravilo, voća, semenja, orašastih plodova, mahunarki i povrća.
And then eat more alkaline forming foods than acid forming foods.
Jedite onu hranu koja izaziva bazičnu reakciju, dakle alkalnu reakciju, ne, više nego onu koja izaziva kiselu reakciju.
And avoid acid formation by choosing correct food combinations.
I izbegnite stvaranje kisele reakcije izabiranjem određene ispravne kombinacije hrane.
Let's just three little rules.
Samo tri mala pravila.
So you want lots of carbohydrates?
Dakle, hoćete mnogo ugljenih hidrata,
less proteins, less fats.
A manje od toga belančevina ili masnoća.
And you want lots of alkaline forming foods compared to acid forming foods.
Želite mnogo više one hrane koja izaziva bazičnu reakciju nego hrane koja izaziva kiselu reakciju.
Now let's look at the high acid forming foods.
Hajde sada da pogledamo hranu koja izaziva kiselu reakciju.
That's all your animal products.
To su sve proizvodi životinjskog porekla.
So if you cut that out,
ako to precrtate,
then you'd only have medium acid like some of the legumes and the nuts and the things in your diet.
Imaćete umereno kisele namirnice koje imaju sada biljke u svom sastavu.
And everything else would just about be alkaline.
A sve ostalo će biti alkalno ili bazično.
And so you only have two rules to worry about now.
Tako da sada imate samo dva pravila o kojima treba da se brinete.
Remember what makes a thing alkaline is the mineral and not the taste.
Setite se da ono što čini hranu alkalnom nije ukus, nego mineral koji se u njoj nalazi.
So a lemon is alkaline forming.
Tako da limun izaziva alkalnu reakciju.
All right, I just want to talk a little bit about feeding young children.
A sada ćemo malo govoriti o ishrani male dece.
Children have smaller stomachs than you have, than adults have.
Deca imaju manji stomak od odraslih.
And children need energy food.
I deci je potrebna hrana bogata energijom.
Now, when we eat only fresh fruits and things like that,
kada jedemo sveže voće i hranu takve vrste,
that's 90% water.
To je 90% voda.
Children need more of the energy-rich foods, the grains, the legumes.
A deci je potrebna hrana bogata energijom, dakle žitarice i mahunarke.
And dried fruit is excellent because that's energy food.
I sušeno voće, na primjer, odlična hrana za njih zato što je bogato energijom.
So all that changes is the proportions on the plate change.
Ono što se menja kod dece jeste proporcija na tanjiru, odnosi.
An adult can have more of the vegetables and the watery things.
Jedan odrastao čovjek može da ima mnogo više povrća i onog što je vodenog sadržaja.
And the child more of the energy rich foods.
A dete više onoga što ima energetsku vrednost.
Now, how do we prepare food?
Kako pripremamo hranu?
You need some useful equipment.
Potrebna vam je neka korisna oprema u kuhinji.
But it's not essential.
Ali nije neophodna.
In Africa, a big black pot.
U Africi veliki crni lonac.
And a fire is fine.
I vatra i to je dovoljno.
And we've gone to the field and had magnificent meals just like that.
I odemo tako u polje i imamo predivne obroke.
But if you want to invite the Queen of England,
ali ako želite da pozovete na obrok englesku kraljicu,
and you're going to use these foods, then a good blender is a good idea.
I želite da koristite ovu hranu, onda je dobar blender dobra osnova za proizvodnju te
and
hrane.
And I put that number one on the list.
I ja sam to stavio kao prvo na listi.
Now don't go buy a blender that's a weak blender.
Nemojte otići i kupiti neki slabi blender.
You want a blender that goes vzzz.
Dakle, mora da bude brz.
Because when you're going to make creams and things out of seeds and nuts.
Jer kad hoćete da proizvedete krem od raznih semenki i orašastih plodova.
And weak blender will never do it properly.
Onaj slabi blender to nikad neće moći da postigne.
And so you will set all these chunks in your mouth.
Onda ćete kasnije imati komadiće još uvek u svojim ustima.
A good frying pan, even a non-stick one, is a good idea.
Dakle, pleh kome se hrana ne zalepi kada se peče.
And then when you become a specialist, you can have waterless cookware.
A kad postanete specijalista, onda možete imati sudove koji kuvaju bez vode.
And a food processor.
I procesor hrane.
And then some people also have wheat mills.
I onda, evo, opcija je da imate i kućnu vodenicu ili vetrenjaču, šta da kažem, kod nas. Najbolje je mlin, dakle.
But I hear that in your country you can get good stone ground flour from the little stone mills all
Ali
over
čuo
the place.
Sam da vi u ovoj zemlji možete da dobijete brašno mleveno na vodenici, to smo mu pričali, dakle da može da se dobije brašno tako dobro mleveno, sporo meljavom, tako da ne morate i da kupite mlin za kuću.
So you don't need all of the stuff.
Tako da vam nije neophodno sve.
One last point, combinations.
A sada poslednja tačka u ovome, kombinacije.
All these rules fall away when you have become a vegetarian.
Sva ova pravila nestaju kada postanete vegetarijanac.
Except there's one.
Osim ovog jednog.
Mixing fruits and vegetables at the same meal.
Mešanje voća i povrća za isti obrok
will cause fermentation.
Izazvaće fermentaciju ili vrenje.
Because the vegetables have heavy cell walls with cellulose.
Zato što povrće ima debelu opnu ćelijsku i mnogo celuloze u sebi.
And take longer to digest.
I treba duže da se vari.
But those plants that have storage energy like the grains and the rich foods.
Ona bogata hrana koja je uskladištila energiju kao što su žitarice na primjer.
Actually digest faster than vegetables.
Se brže vare od povrća.
So, you can eat fruits together with.
Možete jesti voće sa zajedno sa
all grains.
Svim žitaricama,
all legumes,
svim mahunarkama,
all nuts,
svim orašastim plodovima,
all seeds,
sa svim semenjem.
The vegetables that are very watery and don't take much digestion.
I sa nekim povrćem koje je vrlo vodenog sadržaja i ne zahteva mnogo varenja.
And the oil rich fruits like avocados and olives.
I sa uljem bogatim voćem kao što su avokado i masline.
And you can eat all of those together with any vegetable.
A ovo sve možete jesti sa bilo kojim povrćem.
Simple.
Jednostavno.
So that if you want a pudding,
ako želite puding,
and you've had a vegetable meal,
i imate obrok povrća,
you will have to make a pudding with grains and cookies and stuff like that.
Morate
and
napraviti
nut creams and all kinds of stuff.
Morate napraviti dakle taj puding od orašastih plodova ili od nekih žitarica.
So foods like these are neutral because they are water rich.
Ovo voće je bogato vodenim sadržajem i mineralima i zato je neutralno.
So you can eat them with fruits or vegetables.
Tako da možete da ih jedete i sa voćem i sa povrćem.
And within a 24 hour period you want to have mixed a grain with a legume or nuts.
A u toku 24 sata želite da izmešate voće, povrće i mahunarke.
Right, and very important, you want to have a whole food alternative.
A isto tako, vrlo važno, treba da imate alternativu potpune hrane.
For example, kale.
Na primjer, kelj
has 13 micrograms of vitamin E.
Ima 13 jedinica vitamina E.
And 50 milligrams of vitamin C.
I 50 miligrama vitamina C.
That's per 100 grams.
To je na 100 grama.
And when you put it in the whole food, unrefined,
a kada stavite u onu nerafinisanu hranu, dakle tu celokupnu hranu o kojoj govorimo,
that's the equivalent of 800 milligrams of vitamin C.
Imate ekvivalent 800 miligrama vitamina C.
And 1,100 units of vitamin E.
I 1,100 jedinica vitamina E.
So whole food boosts the potential of all the minerals and vitamins.
Tako da ta celokupna hrana sa kojom se ovo koristi daje mogućnost da dođu do izražaja ovi vitamini. Dakle, shvatili ste, to se onda promeša zajedno I onda se najbolje iskoriste ovi vitamini, antioksidanti su dakle onda aktivni.
That's why I said don't refine it, use it.
Ja sam zato rekao nemojte rafinisati nego koristite u onom prirodnom obliku.
This is whole food. This is the whole thing.
Ovo je dakle celokupna hrana.
That's whole food.
Dakle ovo je celokupna
hrana. That's whole food. And start using variety.
I počnite da koristite raznolikost.
And have breakfast.
Imajte doručak.
It reduces your risk of heart disease.
Tako smanjujete rizik od srčanih bolesti.
And it makes you more efficient.
I čini vas efikasnijim.
And puts you in a better mood.
Imate bolje raspoloženje.
And you study better.
I učit ćete bolje.
And please remember variety. That's why I'm showing you variety here.
Molim vas, setite se raznolikosti. Varirajte raznoliko.
Now let's think what we can do.
A sada da kažemo šta možemo da uradimo.
When you think grains,
kada mislite o žitaricama,
people think rice, wheat.
Ljudi obično misle pirinač, pšenica.
That's it.
I to je to.
But there's a lot of grains out there.
Ali ima još mnogo, mnogo žitarica.
If I had to take all the grains and put them in small packets,
kada bih ja uzeo sve žitarice I stavio ih u male paketiće.
I would put them along the wall right around this hall and I would not be finished with the grains by the time I got to that side.
Onda bih poređao te paketiće jedno od drugoga I išli bismo duž zidova ove sale I sve tu I još ne bi izređali sve žitarice.
So start using barley.
Zato počnite da koristite ječam.
It's rich in vitamin B5.
Kod njega imate mnogo vitamina B5.
That helps fat metabolism.
On pomaže u metabolizmu masti.
So you'll actually get thinner.
Tako da ćete smršati.
In the winter you'll produce more heat.
A u toku zime proizvešćete više toplote, bolje ćete se grejati.
So add it to your stews.
Dodajte ih u vaše sosove.
Mix it with rice.
Mešajte sa pirinčem.
Corn is one of the yellow grains.
Kukuruz je ona žuta žitarica.
You can eat it like that. You can make corn meals, corn cookies, all kinds of things with corn.
Možete dakle različito da ga koristite, kuvanog, pečenog, kao slatkiši od kukuruznog brašna u svakom obliku.
This one over here is sorghum.
Ovde je sorghum.
Yes, and rye.
Rye je raž.
And millet.
I proso.
Now millet is bird seed.
Bird. Da, proso je semenje koje jedu ptice.
And of course, birds have beaks.
I naravno, ptice imaju kljun.
And they dehusk the millet.
I one cepaju proso.
But you don't have beaks.
A vi nemate kljun.
So if you had to buy bird seed like it is, you would have a chewing experience par excellence.
Tako da ako kupite proso, a to će za vas biti iskustvo žvakanja samo po sebi.
Birds stay healthy and alive just on millet.
Ptice ostaju zdrave I čitave samo na prosu.
So you must buy dehusked millet.
Tako da treba da kupite proso koje nije oslobođeno ljuske.
Yeah. Now remember millet is an alkaline grain.
Setite se da je proso alkalna hrana.
It's one of the best sources of iron, ladies, remember.
Jedan od najboljih izvora gvožđa, setite se to dame.
Better than meat.
Bolje nego meso.
It protects against arthritis.
Isprečava artritis.
It's rich in lecitin.
Bogat lecitinom.
And you can do magic with millet.
Možete raditi čuda sa prosom.
Cook it like rice.
Da ga skuvate kao pirinač.
One cup to two and a half cups.
Jedna do dve šolje.
You can use it like a breakfast porridge.
Možete da ga koristite kao pahuljice koje se kuje za doručak.
Add some soy milk and something sweet and some raisins and what have you.
Prelijte ga sojnim mlekom, grožđicama, čime god i možete ga pojesti za doručak.
Put the cooked millet in your blender.
Stavite kuvani proso u svoj blender.
And make it smooth.
I sameljite tu masu.
Add something sweet, you can blend dates in there.
Možete da umešate blenderom urme u to.
And you can make a smooth pudding with millet.
I možete od prosa da napravite jedan slatki puding.
You can make spreads with millet.
Možete da prelive napravite od
So you take prosa. A cup of cooked millet.
Uzmete jednu šolju kuvanog prosa.
A little bit of salt.
Malo soli.
Water.
Vode.
Something to make it yellow, turmeric or saffron or something like that.
Mislim da je to neka indijska biljka, turmeric, to je kumin, ili tako nešto. Šafran, žuto, jeste, šafran.
Blend it together.
I to sve izmešate zajedno.
And it looks like that.
I on izgleda evo ovako, kao puding.
It's neutral, it's like a butter, you can use it on your bread.
Neutralan je kao pasta, je možete ga mazati na hleb.
You can put something sweet, something savory on it.
Možete staviti nešto slatko ili slano na njega.
And you could make a pudding with millet.
Možete napraviti puding od prosa.
Blend in some carob powder. Carob.
Carob.
Johannesbrot. Those long beans.
Da, od rogača. Dakle, prah od rogača možete preko toga
And then you make a yellow layer and a chocolate layer and a yellow layer and a chocolate layer.
Tako da onda to bude jedan žuti sloj pa sloj od rogača je brown boje, opet žuti sloj i tako šareno.
And it tastes like a rich instant pudding.
I deluje kao bogati puding.
Start doing magic with oats.
Počnite da od zobi, od ovsa, dakle pravite čuda.
Oats is the easiest one to digest.
Ovas je najlakši za varenje.
So young children and older people.
Tako da mala deca i stariji ljudi.
Also it gives you energy slowly during the day, so it's the best one for breakfast.
Mogu da imaju snage tokom dana, tako da je ova namirnica najbolja za doručak.
I'll tell you in a moment. Rye.
Sada raž.
Very rich in the B groups.
Vrlo bogata vitaminima B grupe.
High in vitamin E.
Visok sadržaj vitamina E.
So the Germans use a lot of rye bread.
Tako da ovog raženog brašna i raži Nemci mnogo koriste.
With muesli you can make fantastic you can use oats for wonderful things.
Dakle možete napraviti muesli, znate šta je to? Od zobi, od svih ovih žitarica.
Imagine a breakfast with rolled oats, nuts, seeds, even pumpkin seeds, dried fruit, shredded
dakle,
coconut,
bundevino,
sunflower,
seme,
and sesame seeds.
Grožđice, orasi, osušeno voće, susam na kraju.
And you put soy milk on that and something sweet and wow.
Stavite sojno mleko na sve to i nešto slatko.
The granolas you buy.
Granola koje kupujete
full of oil.
Pune su ulja.
And it of course oxidizes.
I onda ono oksidira.
Now if you make your own granola,
možete napraviti svoju sopstvenu granolu.
It's a lot cheaper.
Jeftinije.
And you use two ripe bananas.
Uzmete dve zrele banane.
One and a half cup chopped dates.
Jednu i po šolju ovih iscepanih urmi.
Salt.
Soli.
Good salt.
Dobre soli.
Hot water.
Tople vode.
If you want to, a little bit of natural vanilla.
Ako želite malo prirodne vanile.
And you go in your blender.
Sameljete to u blenderu.
And you add it to rolled oats, sunflower seeds, coconut and chopped nuts.
Uzmete oats je ovas ili zob, je li tako? Pa imate suncokretovo seme, kokos i iseckanih oraha na kraju.
And then you at only 130 degrees. That's low.
I samo pečete to na 130 stepeni.
Bake it in the oven for an hour.
Jedan sat pečete u rerni.
You have a fantastic granola.
I imate fantastičnu granolu.
That'll give you so much energy it'll irritate everyone around you.
Tako će vam mnogo snage dati i energije da ćete biti na smetnji svima oko sebe.
And rice, don't refine it. 80% B1, 40% B2, 60% B3 goes missing.
Pirinač, nemojte prihvatiti rafinisan zato što se tako razaraju elementi vitamina B grupe.
If it is too chewy for you,
if it's too chewy for you,
some people don't like unrefined rice.
Neki ljudi ne vole ukus tog nerafinisanog pirinča, dakle on im je onako otužen ustima.
Then soak it before you cook it.
Onda ga potopite pre nego što ga kuvate.
And let's talk a little bit about bread.
Ajde sada da govorimo o raži.
Bread is one of the best energy foods in the world.
About bread or rice?
Bread.
O hlebu sada pričamo.
And now,
ne znam zašto sam ja čuo nešto drugo.
They tell you you get all kinds of wheat allergies.
Kaže se da postoji mnogo različitih vrsta alergija na belo pšenično brašno.
Most wheat allergies are secondary dairy allergies.
Mnoge od tih alergija su u stvari sekundarne alergije na mlečne proizvode.
And when you make a good bread,
a kada napravite dobar hleb,
you can use many grains.
Možete koristiti mnogo vrsta žitarica.
But the lightest bread will be made by using only one grain.
Ali najlakši hleb ćete napraviti od jedne žitarice kao što je pšenica.
You know, most people want to buy a health bread.
Mnogi ljudi hoće da kupe onaj domaći hleb, tako ga mi zovemo.
And they put so much stuff in the bread.
A stave toliko stvari u taj domaći hleb
that you need a wheelbarrow to take it home.
Da vam treba onda onaj dvokolica ili kolica da ih odvezete kući.
And some of these breads are so hard you need a chainsaw to cut a slice.
A tako su neki od tih hlebova tvrdi da vam je potrebna testera da ih presečete.
Yeah. And the breads you buy are refined or they have chemicals added.
A hlebove koje kupujete obično su rafinisani, imaju hemikalije koje su u njih dodate.
So here's a simple bread.
Jedite jednostavan hleb.
1 kilogram stone ground flour.
1 kilogram mlevenog na kamenu celokupnog integralnog brašna.
1 packet instant yeast.
Jedno pakovanje aktivnog kvasca.
Salt.
Soli.
900 ml warm water.
900 ml tople vode.
And something sweet for the yeast.
I nešto slatko za kvasac, ovdje jabuka.
If you're in a hurry, you can use sugar.
Ako ste u žurbi, možete koristiti šećer.
Because the yeast is going to use all the sugar up.
Jer će kvasac iskoristiti sav šećer koji postoji.
You can use honey, you can use molasses.
Možete koristiti med, melase i tako dalje.
But you could also blend a few raisins or currants.
Ali možete također umešati nekoliko grožđica ili nečeg drugog slatkog.
And then you add it.
I onda to dodate.
And now the trick.
A sad trik.
You have to knead it.
Treba da ga mesite.
And you have to develop the gluten.
Treba da razvijete gluten iz brašna.
When you put in a spoon,
kada stavljate kašiku,
the whole bowl must come up.
Treba da se podigne ceo sud.
And it must go, and still be attached to your spoon.
I onda, da kad se spusti, još uvijek bude pričvršćen za kašiku.
And that takes energy.
Tu treba energije.
And if you don't have the energy, get this man. He looks big enough. Get him to do it.
Opet mi se ruga.
And if he's not around,
ako nemate energije, imajte nekog u pripremi koji ima.
Then get the postman, but need it.
Neka poštar onda izmesi hleb, ali potrebno je sa snagom da se izmesi.
Now when it rises,
kada se podigne hleb,
then the gas gets trapped in this chewing up consistency.
Onda se gas u stvari zarobi u toj konzistenciji izmešenog brašna.
If you've just mixed it,
ako samo mešate,
it'll also rise.
Podići će se.
But when you put it in the oven,
ali kad stavite u rernu,
all the gas will escape.
Sav će gas izaći.
And the brick goes,
i hleb će se spustiti.
And you have a brick but not a bread.
Imate ciglu, a nemate hleb.
And you can kill your husband with it but it's not much good.
Možete muža ubiti s tim, ali neće biti dobro.
You want your bread to look like that over there.
Hoćete da vaš hleb izgleda ovako.
It must be light and sweet tasting.
Treba da bude lak i da ima slatkast ukus.
Once you get used to this bread, you will never want to eat other bread.
Kad se naviknete na ovaj hleb, prosto nećete nikad poželeti ni jedan drugi.
Because other bread tastes like cardboard.
Jer će drugi hlebovi u vašim ustima biti kao karton.
Da još jednom ponovimo. 1 kg integralnog pšeničnog brašna, 10 g ili jedna kašika instant aktivnog kvasca, 1,5 kašika soli i nešto slatko. Izmiksana jabuka ili pola šolje suvog grožđa ili u krajnjem slučaju jedna kašika sirovog žutog šećera, meda ili ječmenog slada. Prijatno.